Disclaimer: this is a role play developed as part of the course curriculum for managed TB and online course for doctors. The participants have enacted the role given to them. The case discussed does not refer to any existing patient but has been developed as part of the course curriculum. The investigations, x-rays, and lab reports used in this case scenario belongs to patients treated in NIRT. Their identity have been anonymized.
Good morning, Chief.
Good morning.
I have a case to discuss with you.
Yeah, please go ahead.
There is a 40-year-old woman who is a homemaker presented to my clinic with a history of fever for past 1 month, persistent cough and loss of appetite for past 2 months. She is a known diabetic and on oral hypoglycemic drugs for past 5 years.
What are the additional information you have gathered from her? Stomach examination, etc.?
Yeah, Chief. Along with the examination, I also obtained a detailed history about the patient. On the history part, I have asked about fever, nature of cough, and about loss of appetite and loss of weight. She denies any history of having anti-tuberculous treatment in the past. She also denies history of having contact with any TB patient in his locality or in his workplace. She is a known diabetic, as I said earlier, and now she is on an oral hypoglycemic drugs. I also done the general and the system examination thoroughly.
Okay. So, did you have any investigation reports with you?
Yeah, yes. I have done sputum smear for AFB and also other bacterial investigations. But all the investigation are said to be negative. Along with that, I also done investigation for dengue, malaria and typhoid. Those results are also said to be negative. And I have on chest x-ray to show to you on the abnormalities.
Okay. This chest x-ray shows upper zone opacity. Would you be starting on treatment for pulmonary tuberculosis based on this chest x-ray?
Not definitely, Chief, because chest x-ray is only a complementary diagnostic tool. It is not a confirmatory diagnostic tool. So, there is no need to start a treatment for this patient.
Good, I am glad.
So, shall we order for any CT scan for this patient, Chief? What do you suggest?
In this patient, already you have the chest x-ray abnormality. Then you may not be needing any CT scan in this patient.
Okay, Chief. So, how can we proceed with the patient, Doctor?
If you have not done expert MTB RIF in sputum for this patient earlier, please proceed with doing that test. And how about the sputum production in this patient? What constitutes a good sputum quality sputum collection?
2 ml of mucopurulent sputum is enough to be said as a good sputum sample. With that, we can do gene expert MTB rifampicin test. And for example, sir, if the patient does not give the sample for sputum smear
or testing,
testing.
Yeah, so it's very vital that you collect a very good quality sputum as well as a good volume of sputum. And on top of it, if the patient doesn't produce enough sputum, you may assist him giving an inhalation which would produce a good amount of sputum. And and top of it, you need to ensure that the patient doesn't give you saliva for testing, because the reports depends on good quality and volume of sputum.
Thank you, Chief. So in this patient, what are the further tests to be done?
Could we do MANTO in this patient?
MANTO, I have doubt in it, doctor. Could you please explain about the MANTO?
Okay, so MANTO, mostly it is done to see the TB infection, not the disease. MANTO tests are act as a complementary tool in diagnosis of childhood tuberculosis, as you know that bacteriological confirmation is very difficult in children to get. In adults, normally you should never do MANTO for diagnosing active tuberculosis.
Oh, is it, sir? So, in this patient, so what is the diagnosis and how can you proceed with the management of the patient?
This patient, this is a case of a clinically diagnosed tuberculosis. We go with following things like the patient had symptoms presumptive of tuberculosis, one. Two, he had an abnormal chest x-ray, and most importantly, three is we didn't had any alternate diagnosis to coin it. So, we go for clinically diagnosed pulmonary tuberculosis and treat this patient. Could you just summarize what are the main points we have discussed over this case?
Yes, definitely, Chief. It is important to ensure at least 2 ml of mucopurulent sputum is given for investigation. CT scan is not required if chest x-ray shows abnormality. Positive MANTO indicates TB infection but not TB disease. MANTO is useful in children as a complementary diagnostic tool. Diagnosis of clinically diagnosed TB can be made based on the symptoms of presumptive TB, chest x-ray abnormality, and absence of evidence of alternate diagnosis.